Hello everyone and welcome to Jumperman Tech, where we specialize in HVAC but do everything DIY. And in today's video, we're working on an LG Multi-V unit and we're going to be replacing the compressor and the inverter board. Thank you to everyone tuning in to Jumperman Tech. The first step of this process of removing the compressor to replace it and the inverter board is that we need to recover the refrigerant. As you can see, there is a new error code here, C11 and 211. Currently, the compressor is disconnected because it was faulty. I turned the power off. Luckily, I taped the ends because somebody came up here and turned the power back on. Luckily, it didn't cause any other problems. That's why you always gotta take precaution. Unfortunately, we got a bit of a light rain right now, but I do have this set up right here, and that should help us to recover the refrigerant. It is very tricky with this equipment because we actually have to code it in to the system so we can open up all the EEVs and solenoid valves so we don't have any refrigerant trapped in the system. So let's go ahead and plug that in. It's starting to get a bit bad out here. This is not good. I'm gonna see if we could possibly just at least recover the refrigerant for today. Maybe wait it out a little bit, see what happens, but this is dangerous. I gotta take off this cover, and there's a bunch of boards in here. And to put the system in vacuum mode, the system must remain on. Okay, so there's dip switches here. We're gonna put the dip switch on 5. Function. I'm gonna click the right arrow. Okay, I just had to press a little harder. See, it says SUC. That's actually service. We're gonna click the red button to confirm. You gotta really press these things hard. CC, sir, SE1, we're gonna go to SE3. That's vacuum mode, and then we're gonna click the red button, and then we should hear like a bunch of clicks, and that's all our solenoids and EEVs opening. Awesome, it did it. VACC, we're in vacuum mode. It's the first time doing this. All right. That's awesome. We're zeroed out. Let's open up our gauges. Open, open. You can hear it going in. Start the machine.
Thousand years later.
Alright, so we're pretty much empty. We got 25.3 pounds of refrigerant. Let's put away this equipment. Make sure there's no gas left in any of the lines. I pulled from these two. I hope that's correct. Let me just check that to make sure there's nothing in there. There's 3 pipes coming out of here because this is a heat recovery system. You can have heating and cooling at any time. Very tricky. Anyways, let's continue. We just brought the compressor all the way up around. Got all our equipment here, it's not easy. So, I actually never changed the compressor like this with so many connections. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Thankfully there's no more. And look, this is in the way. I might be able to maybe push it to the side and then maybe pull the compressor out, but the problem is how am I gonna braze all those connections in there? This whole thing gotta come out. Wow. I did not expect that. All right, so I don't wanna mess with any of this while the power is live. We're still in that vacuum mode. So to come out of it, there's a little reset button right there. All right. And that did it. Let's see, maybe those lights will go away, and from there I'm gonna shut the power off. I also gotta put that little dip switch back, I believe. What I'm thinking right now is I can take off these 3 screws, and I could just literally just lay it down on this. Let's see what happens. Chris, help me balance this out. There's a couple screws right there too. No, 1, 2, 2 screws. Let's come on the other side. And then this should take it down. You're gonna have to really actually hold it. That thing is, doesn't look like it's light. All right. I'm gonna hold it from the bottom too. Make sure this thing doesn't drop. Let's see. All right. Oh, you gotta lift it up. You see this is holding it?
Yeah.
Lift it up and pull it back.
There we go.
All right. Then we can wait. Let's watch the wires.
Twist it right here.
All right, guys, we put this panel back on. It's just on and off rain. It's too risky. You know, I still wanted to show up, be reliable and responsible. I did as much as we can, but I think this is just too risky having to pull this panel out. You know, God forbid any of this stuff gets wet and it's just gonna be a whole new set of problems. So I'm actually gonna wrap it up for here. It's Friday. We're gonna come back on a Saturday tomorrow and knock this out. It's gonna be much chillier tomorrow, but it's not gonna be raining. I just don't want any problems to happen. So we're gonna wrap this up one up here. Let's put on the covers and we will be back tomorrow. Rise and shine. It's a new day. It's not raining, but now it's freezing. It's 29 degrees. Great. Let's begin by taking off this panel and getting to that compressor. So we got these two crates, so hopefully we can lay it down on there. So come on this side. Let's together try to carefully pick it up a little and pull it. Let's see. Just make sure nothing's pulling there. All right, we got it like this. Let's start taking some of this stuff apart. We got four connections to make. I see one of them is not being used. All right, so we took off some of these. They just sit on the pipe here so these don't rub out. Got this little heater we gotta take out. And this should be the kind of oil control. So we're gonna take that out. Now we're gonna free up. Gotta disconnect here, 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 and here. Once you get that loose, you can take off four bolts. They should come right out. I should have some flexibility here. There's so many EEVs and so many little valves and everything in here. You really want to run nitro through the system when you're brazing or doing anything like that. I got this whole thing set up right here. But I think if I could just cut these, that would be awesome. Last thing I want is that oxidation in the pipes and clogging us up. Right now I got these two pins. The Schrader valves out here, and if I just open up the nitro, I can see it coming out both, so that's good. So whatever I have like flexibility with, the smaller pipes, I think I'm just gonna cut it out. Cut this pipe out, and I cut this pipe out. As they're small and they're bendable, now I just gotta take out this one and this one. We're gonna unbrace that one. We're gonna run some nitro through it so we don't oxidize. Using hot block heat absorption putty up here, so while we unbraze and braze this, we don't ruin this. Let's see if we can heat this up and pull it out. I don't have fittings this size, so let's see if we can get this done. All right, we're almost there. Right there, hold it right there. Literally breaking off.
Yeah, see that.
Yep.
Awesome.
All right. Now let's get this thing off. One, two. And then this little heater. Take off this little ring. Let's see how this comes out. Crankcase heater. Right there. Let's see how this is gonna come off. It's tie wrapped. Let's get that thing out of here. Got that all loose. Let's go ahead and unbolt the compressor and pull it out. All right. Let's see if we just pull this thing out. It's out. So this line was actually capped off. So we're gonna have to cap that off. Need that little piece of pipe. Cut that piece off, sanded it. I'm just gonna put that in there and braze that. And now we're gonna put it in and make the rest of our connections like that. All right.
Oil's coming out.
Camera kept dying. Anyways, that's the new compressor. Sanded down the connections. Get that in. Get that in. This is kind of in already. This one is not exactly in. We're gonna have to heat it up and smack it in this little bit of braze on the end. And let's start doing this up. Let's start with this one. We're gonna have to hold this down so it really goes in there good. See? Just get it in there like that. Don't let it move. Might have a little oil coming out of here. I'm gonna put in two new Schrader valves. Let's pressurize. I just hope with the system off that when I'm pressurizing, we're actually getting pressure here. Make sure I got no leaks. But then again, a vacuum would also tell us if we have a leak or not. Let's change these that we took off. Get that back on. Pressurize and see if we could find anything. All right, micro leak detector. Wet everything. Everything's looking pretty good. All right, so we threw this panel back on. We dumped the nitro. We can't start the vacuum yet because we got to put this thing in vacuum mode. But I got to change the inverter board. So we got to change the board first, and then put it in vacuum mode because we need power. I can't change this with power on. So take off couple screws here. We're gonna kind of just slide this to the side. They should have just put hinges on this thing, really. And let's see if we could change that board quickly. That right there is the converter, sorry, the inverter board. Here's the one. Customer supplied the parts. Let's hope this thing works. All right, so got our three compressor wires up here. Got one wire here, and then three connectors. Pretty simple. This is all by color. Don't really think you can go too wrong here. So let's start by... I also unplugged this over here just so we had some space. So let's just get the little clips off. I just push that thing back. Out. Out. Is that melted? No. Alright, out. And then 1, 2, 5 large wires. Not that bad. But I believe we're gonna have to put the paste back. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4 screws on each in the back over there. And then 2 screws right here. And that's all that's holding this. This is a used board. And I don't like how it has this coloring here. You see that? Even this board doesn't have that. Is that a sign of overheating? I don't like that. Not lose these screws or anything. So put that back right there for now. It's the only black wire. It's 2 red wires, but this one goes there. Okay. Take that out. Compressor red goes here. Let's get these screws off. The only thing that's bothering me with this job is that when I came here my last visit, I found the compressor and inverter board bad. And for some reason, I'm wearing gloves because of the heat paste on the back. For some reason, it's only been maybe about 3 weeks to a month, and it's bad again. So might be some underlying issues here. I think there's some kind of clips that hold this on the bottom and top. Maybe if I pull that down. Okay. So it was the paste kind of holding us in. Look at that though, look. That guy got the paste all over the board. They just changed this 3 weeks ago. I don't know if this will make any difference, but that could have been one of the reasons why the board failed. This thing is full of the paste. It's only supposed to be on here. They really overdid it here. The heat paste on the control itself. I want to clear this black area so we don't get it all over the board like whoever was here last. And when they put these screws, look, it's cracked. So this is the one they gave me. I don't like these stains here. That one doesn't have stain. That's a new board, but it got all that the silicone heatsink compound. And look at that. It says it's specifically blended with thermally conductive fine metal oxide powders. If that's conductive and you got all that paste all around, that's why that board failed. But I really just don't like this. Ay, ay, ay. Anyways, let's get a little bit of this stuff on. This stuff really has to be on there good. Nice and neat. Let's get this in here nicely. Make sure nothing is in the way. All right, it's in there. Nice and neat. Let's Let's get the screws in. Oh boy. Drop the screw. That one we have to find. Let's get one in for now though. Okay. And we're just gonna put the four screws around. All right, let's not drop this again. All right, board is in. Let's bring this back. Wait, this side gotta go up. Right there, hold it right there. Well, let's get some screws in. All right, guys, this is all set up. Got the heater on nicely. Oil switch, compressor wires, board is on. So I got my regular gauge set on here for these larger pipes with the larger vacuum, and I actually set up the smaller one just with a hose to this small little pipe right there. I got some good news. That's my micron gauge. If there was any leaks, you wouldn't even reach this level. We're at 687 microns. That is a beautiful thing. I can guarantee you there's no leaks in there. All right. So we're gonna let this keep going. We're still in vacuum mode. We're gonna start wrapping up some of the tools, get it off the roof. So the last thing we're gonna do is weigh in the charge on my original visit for recovery, which was the other day when it was raining. We pulled out 23.5 pounds. So pretty much gonna take a whole tank of gas. All right, we got a brand new tank of 410A. Put on the scale, zero it out. Okay, got a full battery. I already purged, it's upside down, so it's liquid. And let's go ahead and start charging it up. We want 25 pounds. All right, valves are open. We're in a pound setting right now. We want 25.3 pounds, exactly what I took out of here. All right, we got 14 pounds in here. Pretty much not gonna take any more. So looks like we gotta start this unit, and we need that compressor to start so we could actually charge this. To take it off vacuum mode, we're just gonna press this button right here, this little reset. Right there. Looks like something's loading. All right, well, let's see what happens. All right, now it's back in function, okay. So I'm gonna take that dip switch off. Okay. Okay, I can hear the compressor started. Pressure's going up. This one's coming down. All right, we gotta charge this thing up to 25 pounds. Okay, good. Now it's coming up. We needed the compressor to start. For a fact that the compressor even started, that is a good sign. I do have this a bit crossed up. I believe this is the suction line. All right, we got 24 pounds and 9.3 ounces. Looks like it's not really gonna take any more than this. So as of right now, I wanna have to use a little bit of this tank just to finish it off. All right, compressor is running, got proper charge. That line is cold, that's good. Got no error codes. The only thing is the condenser fan motor is not running, but that might cycle off some sort of thermistor if it gets to a certain pressure or temperature. But as of right now, looks like everything is good. Maybe the last thing I would maybe want to check is if I can get into one of the rooms to see if we got good temperatures. But pretty much that was it, changing the compressor and an inverter board. Definitely was difficult and a pain, but it is what it is. But we're gonna wrap this one up here. If anyone found this video interesting or helpful, please drop a like, comment, and subscribe as I come out with new videos every week. And I'll catch you all next time.